Hello friends, once again your favorite Dr. Swapnil Prabhulkar have come with the same tagline, simplicity at its best. Friends, I always come with new and new stuff on my channel so that you will enjoy the channel. Wait. If you haven't subscribed the channel yet, hit that subscribe button and hit the bell icon also so that whenever I publish new and new video, you will immediately come to know that Dr. Swapnil Prabhulkar sir have published a new video and you are going to watch it at first. Okay? Now let us see what will be in this video. In number of previous videos, we were talking about the stability of atomic nuclei, right? In that we have also seen that how the neutron to proton ratio is going to affect the stability of atomic nucleus. So in this video, we are going to see about how this neutron to proton ratio is going to affect again. But what is the difference between the previous videos and this one? In previous videos, we have seen that what will happen if the neutron to proton ratio is higher than 1, is very high. In today's video, we are going to see that what will happen if the neutron to proton ratio is very, very low. Yes, again, if neutron to proton ratio, N by P ratio is very low, what will happen? The nucleus will again go to unstable state. And how this nucleus is going to achieve the stable state, that we are going to see today. So basically, we can think of your nucleus can undergo such three types of such processes. Among them, one process is positron emission. Positron emission? What is this positron emission? See, the name itself is suggesting something. Positron. That means it is something related to tron. That is electron. So positron is nothing but the positively charged electron. The way you have subatomic particles, electrons, protons, neutrons, you have positrons also. So what happens in this case? If you have lower neutron to proton ratio. Now what is meaning of lower neutron to proton ratio? Neutron that is in the numerator, proton which is in the denominator will be having higher value. So what is to be disintegrated? Your proton which is in excess is to be disintegrated, right? And this can be obtained, and number of neutrons must be increased. So this can be obtained by again the disintegration of your proton. So what happens in that case? If you have a proton, if that disintegrates into, let us see what will happen, into neutron and electron. This process happens with the emission of antineutrino particles. So we are not going to think of the antineutrino particles. These are not having any charge. But definitely your proton which is having 1 plus charge, 1 mu mass is going to get converted into a neutron which is having 0 charge. So 0 charge and 1 mass. And the electron which is having 1 charge is not negative. It's positive 1 plus 1 charge. And 0 mass, that will give you the positron, and that again goes to give you the antineutrino particles. So let us see how this can be put in one line. So we are going to see how your nucleus is going to achieve stability by positron emission if neutron to proton ratio is high. So neutron to proton ratio low, very low. It's not high, very low. So neutron to proton ratio low means what? Your denominator value is higher, number of protons are higher, and you want to increase the number of neutrons. So let us see how we can achieve it. You have a proton which is having 1 charge, which is having 1 mu mass. This proton gives neutrons which is having 0 charge. Neutrons are neutral particles, so there will not be any charge on them. Yes? And you get 1 mass. The next particle that you get is the electron which is having 1 positive charge. Yes, you can write this as 1 or you can simply write it as plus 1 also. Okay, which is having a negligible mass, and these are the antineutrino particles. These are antineutrino particles. So you have emitted out positrons. This is the positron. This particular E10 is the positron. So what we have done? We have emitted out, your nucleus has emitted out electrons, positively charged electrons, and number of neutrons are increased, and thereby the value of numerator is increased, and therefore the neutron to proton ratio can be increased to bring up to the level of 1. Okay, now what will be the consequences of this that we are going to see, or how this actually happens that we are going to see? So friends, what will be the consequences of this? You have got a positron emitted out. Now positrons are something about the type of electrons. So these positrons, these emitted positrons, will collide with the nearest electrons which are present, because atom is not alone, with nucleus is not alone. Yes. So your atom consists of your subatomic particles, that is the nucleons as well as the electrons. So these positively charged electrons, that are the positrons, collide with the nearest electrons which are present. And due to this collision, what happens, friends? Due to this collision, yes, these particles, see, negatively charged electron and positively charged positron, they are colliding with each other. And because of this, what happens? They annihilate each other. They simply cancel out each other. And this cancellation is at the cost of some release of energy. Yes, any charge neutralization releases out energy. So this charge neutralization also releases out a neutral energy, and that energy comes out in the form of gamma radiations. So what will be the directions of this? This simply will be, the collision takes place and the directions of gamma radiations will be at 180 degrees to each other. That means, if you consider the energy of gamma radiation, say 1.022 million electron volts, what will happen to that? That energy, that means the one particular part or one particular vector of gamma radiation will have half of that energy, and the another will have the half of that energy. That means, if you consider that energy is totally divided in two parts, each gamma radiation, that means the gamma radiations going in each direction, will have half of the original energy, and that energy can be considered as 0.511 electron volts. Yes, and as the energy is released, when we say that energy is released, the system has come down to the lower energy state, the atom will come to the neutral state, or the atom will come to the stable state. Lower the energy, higher is the stability. That's why this is how your positron emission leads to the stability of atomic nucleus, which is having lower neutron to proton ratio. Yes. Now we'll see how this will happen with some examples also. Now friends, we'll take one example. If you have a radioactive nucleus of neon, the atomic number of neon is what? It is noble gas. It has atomic number 10. Yes. And if this neon has atomic mass of 19, right? What is the stable neon's atomic mass? Stable neon's atomic mass comes to be neon 20.183. So you can approximately take it as 20. Now, this neon is radioactive neon, this is unstable neon. And what will be the neutron to proton ratio in this neon? See, you have 10 protons, right? 10 protons, and 19 is the number of protons plus neutrons, that is the nucleons. So the number of neutrons will be 9, right? So let us see what will be this ratio. 9 by 10, simply it is 0.9. This ratio is definitely lesser than 1. What will happen if this neon, that is radioactive or unstable neon, gives out positron? So positron is given out. Because of that, what will happen? One, charge 1, mass 0, positron has emitted out, neutrinos are coming out. Now, due to the emission of neutron, we get another nucleus. Neutron has removed out, so one of the subatomic particles or one of the nucleon is given out, right? and because of that the atomic number will decrease to 9. Atomic number 9 is of which element? It is of urine. Yes, and we are saying that there is no change in this particular part mass, so your mass will be 19. Look at the left hand side, it has 19, it has 19 atomic mass units, it has 10 as atomic charge, 9 plus 1, 10 as atomic charge. So I can safely write here as nuclear reaction is complete. Now this fluorine nucleus is the stable nucleus, and this is how your atomic nucleus of neon has disintegrated into fluorine atom by release of positron, right? Let us see another example. Say one more example. So this was first example. We'll take second example. Now why this fluorine is considered as the stable one? That is very also important, that fluorine has atomic mass of 18.993. So this also can be taken as 19, and therefore your stable fluorine is having 19 as atomic mass. Let us see one more example. See, if you have a carbon, what is the atomic number of carbon? It is 6. Carbon which is having the atomic mass 11. What do we want? We want this ratio of low value. That's why we are going to see how the nucleus is going to unstable. Now let us see what will be the n by p ratio. So what is the number of protons? Number of protons are 6. So n by p ratio, you have denominator as 6. You have number of nucleons, that means protons plus neutrons is 11. So 11 minus 6 will be the number of neutrons, right? 11 minus 6 will be the number of neutrons. So that becomes 5. So 5 by 6 will be equal to 0.833. So definitely this value is also lower than 1. So if such unstable radioactive carbon will disintegrate to give a positron, let us see what will happen. Antineutrinos are given out. You have, so what will happen? As the charge is given out, the charge will be lesser, so it will be say 5. And 5 is the atomic number of element boron. Atomic mass will remain same, right? And therefore, you can see that the ratio is going to decrease. We are going to see what will be the ratio in this case and this case. First of all, understand what will happen to this and why it is stable. So what is the actual atomic mass of stable boron? It is 10.811. So you can safely take it as 11. So is our newly formed nucleus is stable? Yes, it is a nucleus of boron atom having 11 as the mass. Now let us see what will be the ratios, neutron to proton ratios of these two elements that are newly formed. Okay, let us see. The neutron to proton ratios for newly formed so-called stable nuclei. Let us see how they are going to be stable. So what will be the neutron to proton ratio? Here the number of protons is what? It is 9. Number of neutrons will be what? 19 minus 9. So definitely it will become 10 upon 9. Let us see what will be for this. Your number of protons is 5. Nucleons are what? 11. So 11 minus 5, number of neutrons is increased is 6. So what will be the values? Let us see. 10 upon 9 comes to be 1.111, and 6 upon 5 comes to be 1.200. Definitely they are near to 0, near to 1, and therefore your atomic nuclei by loss of or by removal of positron have become stable. So friends, you must have understood very clearly that how your neutron to proton ratio, if the neutron to proton ratio is lower and your nucleus is unstable, that achieves stability by the loss of positron. Now, loss of positron is also going to give you the annihilation of that positron and that positron. See, positively charged electron is not going to remain as it is over there. So what will happen? Definitely, it is going to collide with the electron. It is going to emit out gamma radiation. Yes. And this release in energy is again going to give you back the next nuclei, the daughter nuclei that are formed to the stable state. Hope all of you have understood how this nucleus comes to the stability by emission of positrons. So if you have liked the video, hit that like button, subscribe the channel if you haven't subscribed the channel yet, hit that bell icon so that you will immediately come to know whenever I'll publish a new video. Share the video to all and enjoy the subject.